This is a Minuteman III missile, capable of carrying up to 3 thermonuclear warheads. They range from 3 to 500 kilotons. That's more powerful than 600 million pounds of dynamite. And this is a cutting-edge computer from the early 1990s, and is used as the system processor to launch the Minuteman III intercontinental ballistic missiles.
This is how we would conduct nuclear war on 8-inch floppy disk.
This is an 8-inch floppy disk. It holds just under 250 kilobytes. It's only good for text documents, a super low-res photo, or a song. Right now, there are over 450 Minuteman III missiles buried deep under the fields in the sparsely inhabited regions of the United States. They're connected by a spider web of thousands of miles of cables, ready to strike at top-secret targets faster than you can get a pizza. Welcome to F.E. Warren Air Force Base, home of the 90th Missile Wing. They command 150 of these Minuteman III missiles.
It's hard to imagine a weapon system more powerful than the one we operate.
And yet, these missiles, their launch control centers, and their command capsules all operate on this antiquated technology.
That processor that it uses to basically run the operating system is about a 386 equivalent. So you're looking at early 90s technology. There is a cursor, it's a square, like an old Atari 2600. We use a trackball, not a mouse. And it has 100 megabytes of hard drive memory, and it has about 16 megabytes of RAM. The missile itself, that guidance computer, uses an operating system about the size of the 8-inch floppy disk. It's about 200 kilobytes of memory. So this is the old 8-inch floppy disk. One channel of communication uses that floppy disk to tell the system how to operate.
It was cutting-edge technology back in 1971.
Old technology is not necessarily a bad thing. With an older weapon system like the Minuteman III, which really was designed in the late 60s to early 70s, it still works, and it provides us some good benefits. Let's leave it in place and not mess with it.
There are benefits to old technology. Modern networked computers can be more easily hacked and compromised with malware, and with these machines, that's more difficult.
We don't use modern technologies. I say modern, Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi's been around for decades. Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, there's no cloud for the Minuteman III operating weapon system. We don't use those technologies, and that gives us a lot of security in that because it reduces the number of vulnerabilities we have. To say anything is hacker-proof, absolutely 100%, that's dangerous. And we would never say that we are 100% hacker-proof. We take a great amount of effort to ensure that we are mitigating every potential vulnerability that we can identify.
While these computers may be from the 70s, the missileers who run these facilities skew a bit younger. Most of them are too young to remember the floppy disk at all, not to mention Pac-Man or Pong. In fact, the disks they're handling are, in some cases, older than they are. The missileers look for false alarms and fake intruder signals caused by stray deer and bad weather. The combination of old technology and humans is what has kept the Minuteman III safe so far.
They're old, and we know that. A lot of the obscure technology that we use still works. So if we don't need to upgrade it, then we don't. With the Minuteman III weapon system, because it is so important and so vital, and the destructive power of the weapon system is so vast, above and beyond anything else, we need to ensure that this weapon system is safe and secure. And I can tell you right off the bat that I have absolute confidence in the safety and security of our weapon system and the nuclear weapons that we use on the weapon system.
So although these machines might be antiquated, this is still arguably one of the most powerfully impactful computer systems in human history. So any changes they're going to make will have to be really well thought out and top secret.
For more science documentaries, check out this one right here. Don't forget to subscribe and keep coming back to Seeker for more videos.